Hey, it's Fran, again, in the lab, with a really quick video because I got something that I just got to share with you. It's so geek-tastic. It's the perfect intersection of the things that I love. Pencils, science, toys, and fun. And it's this. Yeah, it's the Palomino Blackwing 811. And I just picked these up. A green pencil. Ooh, so exciting. A green pencil. Well, yes. Well, these are very special. They are not cheap. These actually are the most expensive black wings I've ever bought. But there's a little extra in the green. I think you know where this is going. Yeah, the green is very special. Because these were done especially to commemorate libraries and librarians, and they made the special green paint to emulate the green glass globed lamps that are found in libraries all over the world. And so this paint is very special, as I'm going to show, because I have two cameras running. I have this camera and I have a camera in the other room where I've got the lights turned off, and I'm going to allow these to get a little bit of sunlight, and then I'm gonna go in the other room and show you the magic. Okay, let's go take a look. Oh yes, it's not an illusion. Phosphorescent magic. Yeah, these pencils, they make their own light. Just wow. This is just so cool. Yeah. A true glow in the dark pencil. Yes. Okay, so it's not a trick of the camera. Yeah, they're really phosphorescent. And these really glow. I mean, they really glow. And they glow for a long time. I've actually never seen a glow-in-the-dark thing that actually went so long without like a chemical reaction. I mean, everyone knows about glow sticks, that you can break a capsule, shake it up, and they'll glow for, you know, hours and hours. And those are done by a process of chemical reaction that emits light. So you can have an idea of where the energy source is. But making a phosphorescent coating that will glow for a long time with the absence of any sort of energy pumping into it, it's pretty tricky. So it's actually pretty cool. And I've even noted that you can, if you're writing with one of the, well, obviously if you're writing, you wouldn't be writing in the dark, but you don't have to be in complete darkness to see these things really glow. If you're in subdued lighting, they glow quite noticeably in the hand. And they're also sort of painted in such a way where there's a more phosphorescent ink at the end than at the, so they sort of have a taper to them with the way they glow. So I guess better to use them when they're new than when they're down to a stubby bit. But yeah, I really love this. I'm gonna do some more videos on phosphorescence because I've got some special phosphorescent inks that I've been using to make EL displays, and I've got videos I'm gonna be doing about that. You know where that's going. fun with phosphorescence. Just a short video. Like I said, these things are not cheap, but in my humble, nerdy opinion, these are worth every geeky cent you spend on them. There's just, I mean, just the sheer joy of having something like this in your hand. I don't know. It's hard to put a price on that. Anyway, that's it. It's totally like you know, nothing video, but I thought it was fun, so I hope you thought it was fun. And yeah, these Palomino Blackwing 811s, I got these at the Philadelphia Museum of Art, so I like to buy things there because in addition to being a member there, you know, everything you buy there, part of it goes to, you know, supporting the museum. So, but they carry geek-tastic stuff like this all the time, but you might have to special order a pencil like this, but man, I'll tell you, just really something. Oh, and they're great pencils, of course. These are, have a great sort of harder lead, so perfect for general writing palominos. So that's it for this one. I hope I haven't wasted your time. I hope you like this one. But yeah, I've got some other bigger videos in the pipeline, still sort of sorting the lab. As you know, I did that thing the other day. Been getting my silk screening chops back with the other video that I put up the other day. So we're sort of getting into the swing of things. And I've got more projects dealing with silk screening, phosphorescence, and construction coming up in the next weeks and months. So getting the whole lab ball rolling once again. And thanks to everyone at Patreon for making all these videos possible. You really rock. Thanks a lot. I appreciate it. Always. All right. I'm Fran. I'll see you around the lab real soon. Bye! It's so geek-tastic.